Hello everyone, this is Namrita. Hope you all are doing good and staying safe. Today we'll be covering another topic in Salesforce, which is Salesforce Sandbox Management. Our previous video, we covered a topic related to deployment management using the change sets, right? Wherein we have used a developer sandbox and we made certain changes in our developer sandbox. And then using the change set, what we did, we deployed the changes or migrated the changes from our developer sandbox to the production org, right? So we talked about the developer sandbox and then we also talked about the production. So this is what we are going to cover. So that is what is our agenda for today's session. We will cover or we will understand what is a sandbox, why do we need a sandbox, how to create it, different types of sandboxes which are available, and then we will get into the demo. So what we will do is we'll try to split this into two sessions. Session one will be theory and session two will be a demo. So now let us understand what is a sandbox. Sandbox is a copy of your production org in a separate environment altogether. This specific sandbox can be used for testing, it can be used for development, it can be used for training purposes. So this contains the same metadata or like your production org. Like in your production, you have 10 custom objects, you have 15 approval process and workflow rules or processes, application, all those metadata will be, it will be copied into, it will have the same metadata in the sandboxes as well. So whatever the operations you perform in your sandboxes will not affect your production and vice versa. So if at all you do anything in your production, it will not affect the sandboxes. So it is a isolated environment altogether. That is a separate environment altogether. So mainly if at all you feel that for an organization, if you are in an organization and you wanted to provide a training to your business user. So it is always advisable that you create a sandbox, like a training sandbox. We can make use of the developer sandbox and then perform your training in that specific sandbox rather than touching your production org. So now let us understand how do we log in into the sandboxes. Sandbox, as it is said, it is mainly a testing environment. In order to log in into the testing environment, the URL that you have to key in is test.salesforce.com. Then you have to give your username and password in order to log in into the sandbox. For the production, it is login.salesforce.com. So now let us understand, why do we need a sandbox? So mainly the sandbox can be used for any kind of different kind of purposes, like if you have development, if you wanted to do some testing, performance testing, load testing, or any kind of training you would like to give, you can do it using your creating your sandboxes, making use of that specific sandboxes, you can perform all of these tasks without compromising the data or your application in your production organization. So whatever the changes or the operations that you perform in your sandboxes, it will not affect your production org. So as I said earlier, it is like isolate. It is an isolate environment, separate environment altogether. It will isolate the development work from your production. That is the reason why we need a sandboxes, and always it is a good practice not to make any direct changes or provide any training in the production environment. It is always a best practice to create a sandbox. You have different types of sandboxes according to the business case. You can create a sandbox and make use of those sandboxes for a variety of purposes. How do you create a sandbox? So from the setup, you just have to key in the quick find box, you have to key in the sandboxes, and you can create a new sandbox from your production org. And whenever this creation of a sandbox is always an asynchronous process, which means that you do not have an estimated ETA. That is, you do not have the ETA for that. When you create a sandbox, you are not sure how much time it does take for a sandbox to get created. So now let us understand different types of sandboxes we have. We have developer sandbox, we have developer pro sandbox, partial copy and full copy sandboxes. Let's understand all of these sandboxes in detail. Developer sandbox, main purpose of this sandbox is this type of sandbox can be used for development or any kind of testing. It includes the metadata of your production org. Whatever the metadata you have it in your production, all those will be included in your developer sandbox. However, the storage limit for this developer sandbox is 500 MB and the refresh interval for this specific sandbox is 1 day. That is, you can refresh it once per day, and whatever the metadata you have it in your production will get copied to your developer sandbox. Now let's understand what is a developer pro sandbox. Developer pro sandbox is also, it can be used for the development purposes or any kind of testing. And the major difference is you can host the larger data sets than a developer sandbox. So it has the, it copies the metadata from your production to your developer pro sandbox. This developer pro sandbox can be used to handle more development work. If you have any kind of quality testing, quality assurance, you can make use of this developer pro sandbox. If you have wanted to do some kind of integration testing or any kind of user training, you can make use of this developer pro sandbox. The storage limit for this developer pro is 1 GB. However, the refresh interval remains the same. So the major difference between developer and developer pro is the storage limit, wherein the storage limit for developer is 500 MB and developer pro is 1 GB. And this developer pro sandboxes can host larger data sets, and you can make use of this developer sandboxes for different purposes like for integration testing, or if you wanted to do some complex deploy and development, you can make use of this developer pro sandbox. Let's understand what is a partial copy sandbox. Partial copy sandbox is mainly intended to be used as a testing environment. It copies the metadata from your production, and it also copies partial, that is sample data from the production, whatever you define in your sandbox template. So these type of sandboxes, that is partial copy sandbox, can be used either for quality assurance tasks, like it could be some user acceptance testing, integration testing, or any kind of training purpose. You can make use of this type of sandbox. The storage limit for this sandbox is 5 GB, and refresh interval is 5 days. That is, you can refresh once in 5 days, and it will copy the metadata from your production. Along with the metadata, it will also copy the sample data from the production, whatever you define in your sandbox template. Let's understand what is a full copy, full sandbox. A full sandbox is mainly used for the testing environment. If at all you wanted to support performance testing, load testing, or as a user acceptance testing, you can make use of this full sandbox. So full sandbox is a exact replica, that is whatever the metadata and the data you have it in your production, it contains, the full sandbox contains all of those data and your metadata. It is an exact replica of your production of all the, whatever the objects you have, whatever the files and attachments you have it in your production, this full copy sandbox contains all of those information. The refresh interval for the full copy sandbox is a 29 days, and when the refresh happens, it copies all the metadata, and it also copy the full data from the production. So because of this refresh interval, this type of sandboxes is not preferred for any kind of development work. Suppose if you have it in development work, it is always advisable to either use any of these sandboxes like developer sandbox or developer pro or sandbox. So that is a major differences between these type of sandboxes. According to your business use case, you can either make use of, or you can create a developer sandbox or developer pro or partial copy or a full copy sandbox. Let's take an example. You have a org wherein you wanted to do some kind of development. So for, in order to do the development, you can make use of any of the sandboxes like a developer pro sandbox or developer sandbox. And for the QA testing, you can create a developer pro sandbox or a partial copy sandbox. Based upon number of the sandboxes which are available, you can create those sandboxes according to your business use case. And if at all you want your business to do the end-to-end testing, you can create one full copy sandbox, and you can give access to all your business user, wherein since the full copy sandbox is an exact replica of your production, right? It is always a best practice to provide this, to use this type of full copy, a full sandbox for the user acceptance testing or performance or any kind of load testing. So this is where you can know how many sandboxes are available. Like if you have developer sandbox, it clearly says that I have 30 developer sandboxes available. 5 is something which I've already used. I do not have any developer pro sandbox. I just have one partial copy sandbox. Out of one, already I have used one, and I do not have any full sandbox. So I will show you where we can see this when we get into our demo. So that is what we have for today's session. Second session, we will have a demo. Until then, take care, stay safe. Signing off, Namrata Kariyala. Bye-bye.